I know you don't smoke weed. I know this. But I'm gonna get you high today. Cause it's Friday. You ain't got no job. And you ain't got shit to do.
That makes boxing the ultimate highlight sport. He's the fighter that can get rid of you with one single shot.
When we look at the power, and that's what gets your attention, Joe, but really, ultimately, what gets it done, he has a great sense of timing. His power would be nothing if he didn't get it across so often.
Nice block by Bad Intentions. Good combination to the body. Very nice work to the head. The right hand.
You got my 40, homie.
Against his opponent there. Anytime you can land a three-punch combination, you're really hitting your groove. Is showing you what it takes to be the best in this business. Good, crisp combos.
Cut his movement off. Keep counterattacking, okay? When he throws, make him miss and count. The jab is really working good, right? Just keep using the jab. Gotta keep the jab moving and push him off.
Underway. Well played, straight right hand. King's bang by a big uppercut.
Work the body.
Targeting that midsection now with the combo. Really wanted that uppercut, but just couldn't get it. He takes a shot and then commits to giving one right back. Nice work with the combination by Bad Intentions. Reaching the halfway mark of this round. At this stage of a fight, Teddy, these very early moments, how much in your training career will you stress to a guy to try to go to the bottom?
Very much, because it sets up things later on, and it takes away things that he's trying to do. You know, he's trying to move his upper body. You go downstairs, takes a lot of that away.
Pistols just punching air that time. His opponent was able to get out of the way. A little give and take, and here comes the left hand. Takes a step back, then the counter punch by Bad Intentions.
Very similar to what you see Floyd Mayweather do. You know, make a miss, pull that shoulder back, and then come right back with the counter.
He gets off with a combination up top. Final 10 seconds of round number two. Good shot to the head with that right hand. Coming to the end of this round. Joe and Teddy with you ringside. Teddy, a round like that where it's a lot of busy activity and both guys being busy. When you were a trainer, are those the kind of rounds that you prefer, or do you like the pace to be a little slower? Does it depend on each guy?
No, if I have a fighter, I'd rather have a guy fighting a guy that you never see him. Leave me the heck alone. And where I'm in control all the time. But the fans love to see a fight like that.
can see he's trying to score up top, but off the mark there. That's a fierce left hand that landed by bad intentions. Very nice work with the double jab up top. He took a shot, but he gives one of his own. A left-hand scores. Bad intentions is using that jab well very early on here, Teddy. That could be a big benefit to him tonight.
Well, it's supposed to be, Joe. He has a real good wingspan. I mean, he's got those long arms. No better way to put him to use than to use that jab and use that jab at the right distance.
Left hand by bad intentions. Bad intentions is putting forth that hard work he did in training camp there, landing a crisp combination. Good flush shot by bad intentions. Pistols proving to be elusive. Here's one for you now, he says. Right back with the left hand. The tactical game paying off. You can see the counterpunch.
Yeah, you see the counterpunch, but you know what I see? I see a little tentativeness now in him because he's afraid to let anything go, because when he misses, bang, it gets caught.
You have to start doubling that jab, okay? Double that jab. That will put us in position.
Well, we heard his analysis, but as for how Teddy has scored those first three rounds, here's a look. Do you see any way in which he can take his opponent's aggression and turn it against him?
Yeah, the perfect way. I mean, boxing 101, counterpunching. You got a guy coming at you, no better way than to change his mind. Make him miss, make him pay.
What an excellent two-punch combo by bad intentions. Exchange, he fires back. There he is, working the body.
Focus.
A solid uppercut by Pistol. Halfway through this round here. King swinging and missing like he's at bat right there. That punch was nowhere near his opponent.
Cover up!
Comes right back at him with a left hand. Scored well up top. They trade shots. He comes back with a right hand. Not hitting his mark there going upstairs. Bad intentions is landing a combination here. That's what he does when he's at his very best. And now he's acting like a fighter. Coming back with the right hand after getting scored upon. King's taken a lot of punishment with the right hand. Teddy, you've said many times, it's where you put your own head when you get hit by those right hands.
Well, one place I could tell you where not to put it, in the middle. And he needs to move it to the left outside that right hand.
Scoring well with that combination by bad intentions. And round four comes to an end. Okay. Pistol's down on your scorecard. I snuck a peek at your scorecard. He's down on your scorecard. But it's still a close and competitive fight, a fight that he's very much alive in.
Yeah, he is. But he's got to go about it like the fight is up for grabs. He can't start saying, hey, you know, I think I'm a little bit ahead. Because that's a good way of getting yourself disappointed in anything in life. He better still go after it. Smart, but go after it.
King's jab can do so much there. He used it well that time.
Keep moving. Get out of there.
Little head knocking with that right hand. He digs in, trying to bank away body shots with the combo. Solid straight right hand. fires the combo to the body. Still plenty of time to work here in round number five. Minute and a half to go. And now he scores well with the straight right. Pistol's doing a poor job. There's no other way to really say it. I mean, he's sitting there trying to stay committed to being a counterpuncher. But in the meantime, the fight is getting away from him in a big way.
Yeah, he needs a plan B right now. You know, he came in with plan A, Joe, but plan B is what he needs. He has to find another way to create offense. He's not going to be able to do it countering on the back end.
Not able to land the headshot. Just scored with. He goes down. Oh, he may be close here. Can he survive the round?
2-3.
King's Corner needs to really get to their man after this round. They need to treat him after that.
Told y'all. Told y'all. You want some? Beat him down, beat you down. Who else wants some? Who else wants some of Deebo? Well.
Rick it up. Get up. Rick it up.
Get up.
5-6.
So he's tired. He's got nothing left. Just open ahead. Knock him out.
The start of the sixth round. If there was a baseball umpire around, he'd call that a strikeout by King. Punches and bunches, combination up top. Bad Intentions is being so very effective, punching in combination.
And that's what you want. He's got pretty good hand speed. Might as well use that hand speed. No better way to use it than putting them together.
Nice work on the right hand by Bad Intentions. Oh, he just misses with that headshot. Bad Intentions is doing a nice job being comfortable on the outside.
Move your head.
There's the old 1-2. Eddie, he did a smart thing right there. Just created enough.
Fuck! Yeah! Come on, punk! Come on, little
bitch! Whoop him quick! Whoop his ass!
Everybody!
That's what I'm talking about. That's my dog!
Take that!
You got knocked the fuck out, man! Give me my goddamn money!